If you are planning to travel Hampi, then look no further. I am Utsav.
And I am Urvi.
And we are presenting you internet's most comprehensive guide on how to travel Hampi. Give us your undivided attention for the next couple of minutes as we will present you the best possible way to travel Hampi. Before you proceed any further, if you are new to this channel, please do consider subscribing us. And if you are a regular subscriber, please smash that like button and send us your comments. We'll be ready to help you.
Also, don't forget to follow us on Instagram and Facebook. Hampi is a UNESCO World Heritage Site and it is located in the Indian state of Karnataka. It is an off-beat destination and it is highly preferred by foreign tourists and youngsters. The city of Hampi, located on the banks of Tungabhadra River, was the capital of Vijayanagar Empire in the 14th century. The Vijayanagar Empire was defeated by a coalition of Muslim sultanates and the capital city of Hampi was captured and destroyed in 1565, after which the Hampi remained in ruins.
Its sprawling landscape of enormous boulders, fascinating rock formations, an incredible ancient palace and temple ruins make it an unmissable destination for all types of travelers. It is a budget backpacking destination where you can visit its temples, sit and relax by the Tungabhadra River, or get glimpses of some amazing sunrises and sunsets. Here we present to you a 2-night, 3-day itinerary of Hampi which can be followed by solo, family or budget travelers.
We have divided the entire video into chapters and mentioned the timestamps when each section will start. In this video, we will cover the best time to visit Hampi, how to reach, where to stay, local food, local transport, the detailed itinerary and our complete budget, and at last we will share our tips and recommendations with you.
The best time to visit Hampi is from October to February when the temperature is moderately good.
You can also visit during the Hampi festival which is held in November. It is an annual fair which is held to shed light on the Vijayanagar Empire.
The nearest airport to Hampi is Hubli Airport, which is 166 km away, and the nearest railway station is at Hospet Junction, which is 13 km away. You can also board overnight buses from Pune, Bangalore, Mumbai or Hyderabad and reach Hampi.
You can book your buses from redbus.com or makemytrip.com. You can either opt to stay at Hospet where there are good hotels, but the only downside is it is about 13 kilometers away from main Hampi and the ruins where the major tourist attractions are located.
Hampi is divided by Tungabhadra rivers into two parts. First part, the Hampi side, where temples and ruins are there. The second part is the Hippy Island side, where some of the famous locations like Sanapur Lake and Anjaneya Hills are located.
We stayed at Hippy Island side for a day when we visited Hampi. But unfortunately, the Hippy Island has been demolished by the government. So if you still want to stay at the Hippy Island side, you can opt to stay in the hotels near Sanapur Lake or in Anigunti village where the homestays are located for a more budget option. The best place to stay in Hampi is the Hampi Bazaar, where there are lots of homestays and you can find a decent stay in a reasonable price.
In Hampi, you can find only vegetarian food as it is a pilgrimage for the Hindus, though you can find eggs in some of the restaurants. There are many cafes and restaurants in Hampi and the food is amazing. They serve South Indian thalis, other Indian foods, Tibetan food, continental food, pizza, pasta, pancake and the list goes on.
To get around in Hampi, the best way to commute are autos. The auto drivers are quite nice and helpful. But don't forget to negotiate to get the best rates. To roam around in the Hippy Island, you can rent two-wheelers, but we are not sure what the current situation is. Day 1. Take an overnight bus or train to reach Hospet. Upon reaching, take an auto from hospital to reach your stay and get freshen up, grab some lunch and start to venture out. Take a local ferry to cross the Tungabhadra river. It will take 20 rupees per person, or take an auto to visit the Hippy Island. Start with Sanapur Lake and don't forget to take a Kodakal ride on the Sanapur Lake. Then proceed to Pampa Sarovar and visit the Durga temple there. Lastly, climb the Anjaneya Hills for a spectacular sunset. It might be a bit tiring to climb the 570 steps, but it is worth it at the end. Return back at the guest house, grab some nice dinner and call it a night.
Day 2, get breakfast and book an auto to visit the Hampi site. The ruins of Hampi are divided into two parts, Sacred Center and Royal Center. You will start with Sacred Center and visit Krishna Temple, and opposite to it is the Krishna Bazaar. Just a few meters away is the Ugra Narasimha Temple and Badami Linga Temple in the same temple complex. Then visit underground Shiva Temple. Now head to visit the Royal Center, which has Lotus Temple, Madhava Ranga Temple, Elephant Stable and Queen's Palace. Opposite to that is the Hajara Rama Temple, which is named as there are a large number of Ramayana panels depicted on the walls. Next, visit the Royal Center, where there is a Pushkarini or an ancient staple, Royal Stage and Sacred Royal Chamber. Then head to visit the Queen's Bath. This whole stretch will take about 3 to 4 hours, so start accordingly. Return back to your stay and grab some lunch and rest for some time. In the evening at around 4 pm start again and walk to visit the Hemakuta group of temples. Kadale Kalu and Shashive Kalu temples are the highlights. Then climb the Hemakuta hills and get a nice spot to view the sunset and some amazing view of the Virupaksha temple. Then descend back to the Hampi Bazaar and you can do some shopping from there. They sell a variety of clothes and souvenirs to take back. Get some early dinner and go to bed for an early start the next day.
Day 3. Early morning, visit the Virupaksha temple and after breakfast, walk through one of the 7 Hampi bazaars towards the Matanga hills. Just at the base of the Matanga hills, you will first come across the monolithic bull. Then keep walking following the trail across Yattadaruga Hanumanji temple and head to Achutaraya temple leading to Cartesian Street. Once you cross the Cartesian Street towards the Tungabhadra river bank, there is a Pushkarini to mark the end of the Cartesian Street. Then comes a junction of temple, the Badaha temple and the Ranganatha temple. Take a small detour to visit the Sugriv's cave, which has a significant place in the Ramayanas. Then come back to the main trail to visit the Narasimha temple. Keep following the path and cross the two-storied pavilion to reach the King's Palace. Then just a few meters away is the Vittala temple, where you can visit the famous stone chariot of Hampi. On the way back, visit the inscribed Vishnu temple. Take a detour to walk along the Tungabhadra river banks to visit the Purandara Dasa Mantapa. Then cross the sacred banyan tree on the left and head towards the Bhagwan Veda Vaishya Ashram. Sit there and relax for some time, as this is the end of the tiring but worth taking trail. You can also enjoy Kodakal rides here. It takes about 3 hours to complete the entire trail. After some relaxation, head towards the restaurant to get some sumptuous lunch and by taking an auto, reach hospital to take your bus to head home. Let us give you a breakdown of the cost for 2 person. AC sleeper bus costs 1200 rupees per person. So the to and fro journey for 2 persons will cost 4800 rupees. The auto ride from hospital to Hampi will cost rupees 300. Hotel AC or non-AC ranges from 600 to 1500 rupees. So we are taking an average of 1000 rupees for 2 nights, that is equal to 2000 rupees.
food will cost 1500 rupees per day for 2 persons, and for 3 days the total will be 4500 rupees. For sightseeing, the auto will take 2000 rupees. Again, from Hampi to Hospit, the auto ride will cost around 300 rupees. And we have taken a miscellaneous cost of 1000 rupees for the entry and other things. The total comes to around 15,000 rupees for 2 persons.
As it is quite hot, even in the winter season, we would suggest you to wear cotton clothes. Also carry an umbrella, sunglasses and sunscreen, and don't forget to stay hydrated.
For food, we highly recommend the Mango Tree restaurant for a South Indian thali, Funky Monkey and the Gopi Guest House rooftop restaurant.
Don't forget to go on a Kodakal ride at the Sanapur Lake. We suggest you watch an amazing sunset from the Anjaneya Hills and the Hemakuta Hills. Take a walk from the Matanga Hills to the Vittala Temple. Though it might be a bit taxing, but it is totally worth it.
If you are just here for the Hampi itinerary, then you can skip the upcoming sections. But if you are part of the Bonkersner family and you are wondering about our upcoming vlogs and travel plans, then we thought of letting you know here. By now, from our Pauna Lake vlog, you must have come to know that we had visited Pondicherry way back in February before the pandemic had started. But we were not quite sure of the entire pandemic situation, and we thought it would be inappropriate at that time to post a travel vlog.
As things are getting normal again and the restrictions have been lifted, so we have started traveling again, keeping in mind the safety and the local restrictions. So from the next vlog, we'll come up with our Pondicherry series and follow it up with our Mumbai vlogs. From now on, we will be posting every Sunday at 10 a.m. on YouTube. In YouTube, we are generally behind by 1 month. And to know our current whereabouts, please follow us on Instagram.